Aquarium is closed for a little while, but curiosity is never canceled. Join us as we dive into some of the mysteries surrounding some of your favorite animals.
Today we're taking a closer look at sharks. What do sharks really eat? How much do they eat? How big are sharks? And why do oceans need them? Let's dive in!
Which of these do you think a shark could eat? Fish? Clams? Crabs? Plants? Sea lions? If you guessed all of the above, you're right. We share our world with hundreds of shark species. Not only do they often look different, but many of them also eat very different foods. So fish, clams, crabs, seagrasses, and sea lions are all foods that could end up in a shark's stomach, depending on what kind of shark does the eating.
A shark's body often reveals clues about what and how it eats. Let's take a closer look at the sandbar shark. What do you notice about the shape of its body? Like other animals that move quickly in water, a sandbar shark is thick in the middle and narrow at each end. Its narrow tail allows it to turn quickly in the water too. Its triangular teeth are sharp and a little jagged along the sides like a knife. Which of these foods do you think a sandbar shark would be best at eating? Fish, clams, or plants? A sandbar shark can eat many animals, but it's particularly well suited to chasing quick-moving fish and grabbing them with their teeth as they swim. Next, let's look at the zebra shark. Its more cylindrical body and long tail means it cruises instead of races through the water. Tiny pointed teeth line flattened plates inside its mouth. The mouth sucks food from tight spaces like a vacuum cleaner, and its jaws crush food like a nutcracker. Which of these foods do you think a zebra shark is best at eating? Fish, clams, or sea lions? Instead of chasing a meal, a zebra shark usually searches for animals with hard shells, like clams. Then they suck the animal out of the spaces they live before cracking the shell with its powerful jaws. A wabigon shark is made for neither racing nor cruising. Its rounder, flatter body rests on the ocean floor where it can spend most of its day. Take a look at its mouth. When a wabigon shark feels food brushing up against those tassels, it springs into action, gripping its prey with its curved teeth like a clamp before swallowing. Which of these foods do you think a wabigon shark is best at eating? Plants, sea lions, or crabs? Hiding on the ocean floor, a wabigon shark relies on ambushing its meal. It often chooses a meal that frequents the ocean floor, like a crab. Reaching lengths of up to 40 feet, a whale shark is the largest fish in our oceans. Its open mouth is almost as wide as a refrigerator. At mealtime, the whale shark opens its large mouth and water gushes in, carrying food with it. Inside its mouth, a whale shark has filtering pads that separate the food from the water like a strainer. Which of these food items do you think a whale shark is best at eating? Sea lions, clams, zooplankton? Despite being one of the largest animals in the ocean, whale sharks eat the smallest prey, including fish eggs and zooplankton. Whale sharks actually have some teeth, but they don't use them for eating. Some scientists believe that they have no function at all.
Sharks slice, tear, chomp, crush, clam, and strain their meal.
Do you slice, tear, crush, clamp, or strain any of your food when you're eating? How many other ways do you eat your food? Do you nibble, slurp, suck, chomp, catch? What else do you do?
We now know sharks can eat different foods in different ways, and so can we. But who do you think eats more, you or a shark? Think about everything you could eat in a day. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, snacks. drinks? If you put it all together, how much do you think it weighs? What about sharks?
Earlier, we talked about what some sharks eat in the wild. Here at Shed, sharks eat restaurant-quality seafood at every meal. One meal could include six or more types of seafood like salmon, squid, pollock, capelin, mackerel, mullet, herring, or shrimp. Just like you have your favorites, individual sharks have their favorites too. We have a kitchen where we prepare food for approximately 20 sharks that call the Wild Reef exhibit home. We measure and hand cut each piece of fish. This way, we know exactly how much each shark eats. Many factors play a role in determining a shark's appetite and how much food it needs. One factor is its weight.
The average zebra shark weighs about 108 pounds. About how much do you think it eats in an average meal? 500 pounds? 50 pounds? 5 pounds? 0.5 pounds. A zebra shark usually eats a little over half a pound of food per meal. That's a little less than the weight of a single can of soup. Now let's turn our attention to a bigger shark. A sandbar shark weighs between 110 and 150 pounds. Females tend to be larger than the males. How many pounds of food do you think a shark this size eats in an average meal? 2,600 pounds? 260 pounds? 26 pounds? 2.6 pounds? A sandbar shark can eat up to 2.6 pounds, the weight of about two basketballs. So who eats more in one meal, you or a shark? Maybe you eat more, or maybe it's a little close between you and the shark. Let's examine how much these sharks eat in a week. Zebra sharks eat one meal every day. Sandbar sharks eat one meal only three times per week. That means 4 days a week, sandbar sharks don't eat anything at all. Think about how many times you eat each day and multiply that by seven. You probably eat more than a shark.
True or false? Most sharks are small.
We know the amount sharks eat is based partly on their size. But how big are sharks really? Who's bigger, you or a shark? When we picture a shark in our minds, we usually imagine something pretty big, like a great white shark, which can reach 20 feet in length. But the average shark is closer to 5 or 7 feet long. That's the height of most adults. Let's measure. A zebra shark can get up to 8 feet long, but most of that is its long tail. Sandbar sharks average about 6 feet. Black-tip reef sharks measure in between 3 and 4 feet. A swell shark is about 35 inches long, but they can fill their stomachs with water and swell to twice their size to ward off predators. A wobbegong shark reaches adult size at about 4 feet. Adult bamboo sharks are between 2 and 3 feet long. How many sharks are the same size you are or smaller?
True or false? Some sharks are friendly.
Like dogs or cats, sharks often have distinct personalities. Zebra sharks are sometimes described as the Labrador retrievers of the shark world because of their curiosity, gentleness, and friendliness. One zebra shark in particular even seems to enjoy the feeling of the bubbles from our regulators when we dive in the shark habitat. She'll spend most of the time we're in the water with her, swimming in and out of the bubbles we produce.
So, if some sharks are friendly, are some sharks dangerous to people?
Let's consider some examples. As we've discovered today, most sharks are predators that are built to eat certain kinds of food, like fish, clams, crabs, plants, and sea lions. Shark attacks, which are pretty rare, usually happen when a shark mistakes a person for an animal they prefer to eat and takes a bite.
Take a look at these images. On the top, you have a sea lion. On the bottom, you have a person on a surfboard with their arms and legs hanging over the edges. Do you see how a shark might confuse the two? Have you ever eaten something you don't like by mistake? What did you do?
Usually when a shark accidentally bites a person, they do what most of us would do when we accidentally eat the wrong thing. Spit it out. Here at Shed, we dive among sharks almost every day to feed animals that don't usually swim to the surface and to clean or inspect the habitat. In the wild, swimming among sharks is increasingly common. Dive tourism, when managed properly, is a great way to experience sharks in the wild. Shark attacks seem like big news when we hear about them a few times a year, but that's because they're so rare. We're more likely to be struck by lightning or be bitten by another person than to be attacked by a shark.
It's important that we understand and appreciate sharks because they play an important role in keeping our oceans healthy. Can you guess what it is? Think about how sharks might use their roles as a predator to benefit the overall health of the oceans. If weak, unhealthy animals stayed in our oceans, what do you think would happen to future generations of animals? Would they be healthy or unhealthy?
One important reason our oceans need sharks is to prey on weaker, less healthy animals. When sharks eat those animals, stronger, healthier animals remain to breed future generations of strong, healthy animals. This helps maintain a balanced ecosystem. You might think nothing could hurt the ocean's top predators, but the truth is, sharks need protecting.
Aquarists, researchers, and other shark lovers are hard at work studying ways to keep sharks safe in the oceans. What are some other things we can all do to keep sharks safe in our oceans?
We can learn as much about sharks as we can and tell positive stories about sharks. Many people have the wrong idea about sharks. Has anyone ever had the wrong idea about you?
When you share a story about how sharks balance our ecosystem, or how many sharks are small and how some are friendly, you make it harder to abuse sharks and easier to protect sharks. You can also read the ingredients of the things you buy and make sure nothing comes from sharks. Watch out for squalene, another word for shark liver oil. You might find it in lotions and lip balms.
Keep trash out of our oceans. Limit the things you buy. Think carefully about how you get rid of things you don't want anymore. Take your old things and create something new whenever you can. Make a bag out of old t-shirts. Create toys out of old plastic bottles. Don't miss a chance to convert trash to treasures. You can have fun while keeping a shark's home clean and safe. Today we solved the mysteries of what sharks really eat. How much do they eat? How big are sharks? And why do oceans need them? Which shark story will you share? Let us know.
Join us next time, and thank you for staying home with Shed. To continue exploring shark mysteries, visit Shed Aquarium online.